G'day guys. I was going to go on a bit of a fishing mission last night, but it was my first day at work yesterday, and yeah, pretty much a broken ass, so decided to just hunker down for the night. Weather's a bit choppy for a fish, I think, so just gonna show you my hammock shelter and just my my go bag, what I take for day missions and the occasional overnighter, and yeah, just for bushcrafting and whatnot. So yeah, this is my hammock. It's quite comfy. Being it's the middle of summer, it's quite hot, and yeah, snug as a bug now. All right, just give you the tour of my my shelter, I suppose. Sweet.
It's actually quite chilly during the night, so I always, when I go into these hammocks, I always sleep on top of the sleeping bag as opposed to in it, because yeah, it just feels way better. Pros and cons with these hammocks is that there's bugs around, you're gonna get stung, so yeah, try and I always wear a jacket just to protect myself, because sometimes I like rest my head on the net. And best way to lie on these is on an angle as opposed to just straight. It's just way more comfortable, and it changes everything if you just sleep on an angle. I'm shaking. So you can lie straight, but yeah, sometimes you'll wobble around in the night on an angle like this. Nah, comfy as. I think the only drawback I've found when using these hammocks is the sleep's so comfortable that I can't even wake up to my alarm. But yeah, nah, it's pretty good. This is my go-to shelter for pretty much everything now. I'll only use a tent if I'm up on the up on tussock tops and with somebody. If not, yeah, nah, just pack this. It's easy as. Yeah, I just use my summer sleeping bag, and just have that as the bottom layer. Yeah, and when it gets colder during the raw and that, I just switch out to my winter sleeping bag and sleep on top of that, and probably have a swanny or a jacket on, and yeah, snug as a bug. I don't know what it's like in snowy conditions. I'm picking on what use thermals, and I got enough space in my bag for thermals too if I need to, so yeah, that's a work in progress. I'll probably do that next winter and have a look. Oh yeah, my my bungee system is pretty basic. I'm 105 kgs, and yeah, it held up. Heard a couple of tings, but yeah, that's from this, and it's not breaking. It just means that it's stretching. If it breaks, you'll know about it. But yeah, I've used this quite a lot, and I've had no breaks on it, so it's quite good. Good things about this system is that you can customize the harnessing systems all by yourself. If you know how to do all that, and extend it out, and yeah, just modify it how you want to. And it's quite quick to pack away. It's a bit of a, it's kind of a mish to set up, but it's quite fun. If you do it right the first time, yeah, you kind of get used to it. And yeah, you kind of can figure out where you need to sit and whatnot. Takes a bit to get used to, but yeah, practice makes perfect. If you're ever gonna get these gear like this, always field test it before you take it out out in the bush, because there's nothing wrong with having equipment fail on you when you're out in the bush. So just keep that in mind too. Always field test your gear first.
Preacher's son, and when his daddy would visit, he'd come along. When they gather around and started talking, Cousin Billy would take me walking. Out through the backyard we go walking. Then he'd look into my eyes. Lord knows, to my surprise, the only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. You see what he was. Yes, he was. Being good isn't always easy, no matter how hard I try. When he started sweet talking to me, he'd come and tell me everything is alright. He'd kiss and tell me everything's alright. Can I get away again tonight? The only one who could ever reach me was the son of a preacher man. The only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. Lord, oh, he was.
Yes, he was.
How will I remember the look was in his eyes? Stealing kisses from me on the sly, taking time to make time, telling me that he's all mine. Learning from each other's knowing, looking to see how preacher man, the only boy who could ever teach me was the son of a preacher man. Yes, he was. He was. Oh, yes, he was. He was the sweet talking son of a preacher man.
The only boy who could ever teach me was
the son of a preacher man.
The only one who could ever
teach me
was
the son of a preacher man.
Easy as pigs it up.
So this is pretty much my
my day bag. This one right here. I've already got my cooker and some food already in there. This is a Roman palm light.
It's not too bad. Summer, spring, and early winter, that should be alright. Well, it's alright for me anyway. Stony Creek drone. This hammock I bought for 30 bucks on Trade Me. Yeah, it's cheap and affordable. It's quite good. And plus Tusker jacket, pretty good. This is just my bushcrafty knife, just a junior goober type thing. When I first started out, I used to hate on this, so I started giving it a good hiding, and yeah, it hasn't failed me yet, so it's not too bad. I'd rather have this one as opposed to that big long one. This is just more robust. Yeah, just a scabbard here for my rifle if I ever take one. Yeah, this is a pretty good pack.
Pretty nifty spot. I quite like this bag because you can tighten it up, it glues onto you, and it doesn't rattle or anything like that. Even the rifle scabbard's quite good. The gun doesn't shake around or anything, and it just locks into place. It's quite a good bag. I don't know the name of it. It's just a Ridgeline day pack. I think it's a 25 liter, I think. And also it's quite light too. All the gear that I've got now, I weighed it all in at around about 6 kgs, which is quite light for me. But this is a pretty good pack, and pretty much my go-to pack for all my adventures. I would generally use my big pack just primarily for big hunting missions. I've used this for 2 years now and no rips or anything like that. I've had a deer on the back and held the weight and made it a bit more comfortable. Didn't need to do any carry out me if it's just straight on the back, and it's pretty good. And if I ever need to butcher a deer or anything like that, I can always just take out some gear, put it in a dry bag, and just put it underneath, because there's some straps for that as well. It's quite a good bag. Hope you guys enjoyed that. I had a good rest. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do now. Hope you guys enjoyed that, and see you guys on the next one. Cheers.